Hello friend, this is Professor Samir Sheikh. I am Assistant Professor at N.B. Nawalia Singh College of Engineering, Sholapur. I have total 15 years of experience and I am specialized in CAD/CAM and automation. So we were discussing about the 7th unit in CAD/CAM and CAE, which is tooling for CNC machines. In the previous sessions, we have seen what is tool magazine, what are different types of tool magazines, and we have also seen what is automatic tool changing arm or ATC. In today's session, we will discuss what is tool holders and adapters. Okay, so basically a cutting tool is used in CNC machine is an assembly of number of parts. The basic idea behind the tool holders and adapters is basically to hold the cutting tool into the machining center, into the spindle of the cutting of the machine. So we, of course, we know that the spindle rotates with very high speeds, so because of that the cutting tool also rotates. So basically holders and adapters are basically used for holding the cutting tools inside the spindle. So it is not a single unit, it is an assembly of different number of parts as shown over here. So the assembly generally consists of 4-5 number of components, like retention knob. This is your retention knob over here. Then we have adapter here, which is a tapered element. This is your adapter. We have a collet here, which is a small part here. This collet, this cross section is collet, and we have the actual cutting tool. We do also have a collet nut here also, right? This is a schematic of it. You can see that a cross section has been taken to highlight various sections of the assembly. The next figure shows actual cut section of what a cutting tool might consist of, what a cutting tool assembly might consist of. Okay, so this is a retention knob, okay, which of course after the cross section you can see that it has been held inside the adapter by threading arrangement. This is complete your adapter, which is a tapered section. We have a collet over here. This portion is collet, and this is your collet nut, and this is your cutting tool, right? So this is basically a actual cut section of a cutting tool that is used for machining operations, right? So the adapter, which is basically a tapered portion, is used to hold the cutting tool assembly inside the spindle taper. So the function of adapter is basically to hold this complete assembly inside spindle taper, so that when the spindle rotates at a very high speed, the cutting tool also rotates with it. So function of adapter is to hold the tool assembly inside the spindle taper. Now collet is basically used for holding the straight shank of the cutter. You might be aware about this kind of figures. This is basically a collet. Okay, small serrations are present. They are not completely throughout the object. They are partially drilled over or partially slotted over here, so that the tool shank. This is the shank of the cutting tool. This shank goes inside it, and when you tighten the collet nut around it, it is going to get compressed and it will hold the cutting tool inside the cutting tool assembly, right? This is the function of collet. Then we have retention knob also, which is used by the hydraulic drawbar in the spindle housing for retaining or releasing the tool from the spindle. This knob is basically used for retention and releasing of the tool from the spindle. So there are two types of arrangements for this. One is a collet type, which is obviously just like this collet type, and the second is a ball type arrangement, which is basically a gas cylinder and a regulator type of arrangement. So you have two arrangements for retaining and releasing the cutting tool assembly inside the spindle. As you can see over here, this retention knob will go inside the taper, inside the spindle taper. So we need to at least retain it or release it. That is the function of this retention knob over here. So basically, tool holder is an essential connection between the machining center and the cutting tool. Okay, machining center as in the spindle and the cutting tool. It's a essential connection between the two, right? Your cutting tool and your cutter tool holder. So it's a connection between the two. The tool holder fits into and is secured by the machining center spindle, and in turns secure the cutting tool, such as a drill or a end mill, by clamping onto its shank. So what we are saying over here is the cutting tool and the spindle portion, which is available in the spindle tipper, it's a essential connection. So my objective here is to make a connection between the machining center, right, the spindle which is available over here, with the cutting tool. So all these components will become essential connection. Okay, so that is what has been said here. The tool holder fits into and is secured by the machining center spindle, and in turn secures the cutting tool also, for example a drill or mill, by clamping into its shank. So the taper of the tool holder matches the tool holder interface of a particular spindle. Of course, the taper of the tool holder matches with the taper of the spindle also. Okay, so there is a close fit or a very fine interface, surface interface between the two. Okay, so tool holders are used different mechanism for clamping the tools. Now this taper, which is used for clamping the cutting tool assembly inside the spindle, is a very essential part, essential connection between the two. Okay, but at the same time, the cutting tool shank also uses different mechanisms for holding the cutting tool inside the adapter, right? The first arrangement is set screw type of arrangement, wherein you can see that a hole is being drilled inside the adapter and the cutting tool is inserted inside the adapter, and using a wrench or an Allen key, this tool is secured here. So it is to make sure that when the cutting tool assembly rotates with the spindle, the cutting tool should move exactly with the same degree of rotation. There should not be any slip, otherwise the machining operation will not be performed very smoothly and it can break or give very worse results. So you can have a very good secure connection by using set screw, can clamp onto a corresponding flat in the tool's shank. So we can have a flat here just like this, okay, inside the tool shank. So our screw is going to set on this particular flat, and we can tight it by using Allen key or a particular kind of wrench arrangement. So this is how the cutting tool is been hold inside the adapter. The second type of arrangement that we have discussed is a collet. This is the collet, and this is the arrangement wherein the shank of the tool is been placed inside the collet, and after that the collet nut has been inserted from the top and it has been tightened. So this portion gets compressed and it will ultimately put certain pressure on the shank, and the assembly will be acting as a one device. Okay, the third type of arrangement is nothing but hydraulic tool holders, where it compresses the bladder of the hydraulic fluid. Okay, so this is the adapter. Okay, this is the flange wherein an arrangement has been made where hydraulic fluids are used to pressurize the shank. This is a cross section of that arrangement, and you can see that over here we are using a special tool which is used for tightening or loosening a particular kind of screw over here, and slots have been drilled or slots have been made inside this particular flange so that it carries a kind of a fluid inside it. So it's a cylindrical portion. This cross section is cylindrical around the tool shank. So once the tool is placed, the tool shank is placed inside the adapter, I am going to tighten this up screw. So there is, the fluid has no other way to go, So as and when I apply more pressure over here, the fluid is going to put lot of pressure around the circumference of the tool shank, and that is how it is going to get compressed and get secure inside the adapter. This is nothing but hydraulic fluid adapters, okay. And of course they are very costly to use, and manufacturing wise they are very difficult, so the cost of these kind of tool holders is very high compared to other type of tool holders. The last option is shrink type of tool holders. Of course the name itself suggests that it is going to use the thermal expansion and contraction of the particular material. This is the tool adapter wherein a special kind of machine is being used to heat up this particular arrangement so that it will expand. Once it expands, it is going to increase in its diameter and the tool will be placed inside the adapter. Once it and of course after a certain time it is going to get cooled up and it will get securely placed inside the adapter. So we have a very good fit between this adapter and the cutting tool. But the disadvantage over here is that it takes lot of time for making sure that the cutting tool is being placed inside the adapter, because the time required for cooling will be very much high. So generally this is not preferred, but nowadays machines have come up where after putting the cutting tool inside the adapter, it has been immediately cooled inside the water. So this particular arrangement will go inside this particular section and it has been cooled inside this. Of course we have a tank of water over here and it will be cooled within minutes instead of 10 to 20 minutes. It will be get cooled in 2 to 3 minutes. So that way you can increase the performance of this kind of shrink fit tool holders, but not very popular with the system. The most popular type of tool holders are collet type of things, which are very much easy to release and tighten up. Okay, so that is how basically the tool holders and adapters are going to work in this particular system. So that's it for this session. We'll stop here. Thank you.